Oscar's girlfriend says that she has the biggest crush on you and she wore a hat just for you today.
Yeah, I know. He told me and...
it's a compliment.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're married. You're happy.
Yes, I am.
He made a joke that you're the hope, you're the one pass.
Yeah, I know that. she was joking.
Yeah, of course. Now, you look great today.
Yeah.
You're hitting hard, you're fluid, you're slick. We're going to have an exciting fight.
Yeah.
I don't think it goes 6 rounds. I think.
Me neither.
We don't know, but you're prepared for 12.
Yeah, I prepared for 12 rounds and I prepared for win. I prepared for raise my hand. I visualize myself all the time and the time will come.
Oscar said something today. He said that Bivol would beat Canelo 10 out of 10. What do you think?
Right now or the rematch?
No, 10 times. Like another 9 times.
Yeah, for sure.
You think so? Why?
Yeah, because the football that he has, Canelo, he wasn't like really focused in that fight. But at the end of the day, Bivol is better fighter in the field. And I mean, nothing wrong with that.
But you,
is pound for pound
to me, he's number one pound for pound.
Yeah, for me too. And he should stay in 68 for now and beyond.
Him and Triple G, Canelo by knockout.
Yes.
Him and... what's it, John Ryder?
John Ryder?
If Canelo goes to England and fights him?
Yeah, Canelo.
Not bad. Benavides, you told me yesterday, 50-50.
Yeah, 50-50.
But a lot of big fights, exciting fights.
I know. I love both of them. I like to watch it. It's exciting. As a fan, I love to watch Benavides, Canelo, and even Bivol. I watch it. And all of them, I like to watch all the boxers. But as a fighter, I know I'm the best, I'm confident, and I know I can beat anyone.
I was on my live, I told people you would cook Bitterbrive.
Yes.
You would cook them.
Yes, of course.
And you and Bivol, great fight, I hope it happens. Yeah. If you win, which I hope you do, you become his mandatory.
Yes, I will.
And what would happen if you fight Bivol?
I read my hand.
Decision or knockout, what do you think?
I think decision.
He's a great boxer, you're a great boxer, yeah. Southpaw.
Yeah, it would be exciting fight for both of them. But we know each other.
Nice guy. You're a nice guy. Yeah. Very professional.
Yeah. And
it's just the best fighting the best.
Yeah, that's it. You don't have to talk shit. You don't have to tell anyone something. But at the end of the day, we want to be the best and we have to
fight the best. That's true. Now, did you have a chance to watch your opponent today, the German kid?
Yes.
What did you see?
He's a nice guy.
Very nice guy. Very professional. Yeah. Looks like one of the guys from England, like Billy Joe Saunders, right?
Yeah. He looked tough.
Strong guy. He told me he's a good boxer. Did you see good boxing skills? Did you see footwork? Did you see speed?
Well, I don't see much because I was in the interview and he didn't move well. But for me, I don't care. It's like training. I had to train. I had to do my job. And at the end of the day, in the fight, it's different when you get hit.
What did Mike Tyson say? Everyone has a plan until what?
Yeah, until they get hit.
Until they get hit. So what are they doing right now over there? They playing chess? Yeah.
No, nothing. They're just watching TikTok.
Julian, what are you watching right now? Are you watching TikTok videos?
TikTok.
That's
it. Zurdo
saying you watch it. What is Chris doing?
I don't even have a TikTok. TikTok.
They're both watching TikTok?
Yeah. I don't even have TikTok.
If you had a TikTok, would you post dance videos?
Like Zurdo?
I'll do it by myself.
Do you have a TikTok?
I would like to be in a.
He wants to be TikTok famous.
Yeah.
Easy.
Yeah, but
no problem.
But I want to be a Dancing with the Stars.
You want to be Dancing with the Stars? No problem.
This is Jalen. This is part of the gym, part of the boxing.
Sugar Ray Leonard did it. Floyd Mayweather did it. Victor Ortiz did it. Why not Zurdo?
Yeah, of course.
You think you could dance though?
Of course.
Would you win?
Yeah. Sure.
What we do, merengue, salsa, or
anything.
Break dance? Do you know how to do the robot?
Yeah.
Can you dance?
Yeah, I can dance.
Let's see a little bit.
That's why I had good...
Good footwork?
Good footwork, because he can dance.
Can you dance?
I'd like to say that I can dance.
Can you show us a little sample?
No, absolutely twerk. Not.
She know how to do twerk.
What did you think of the Canelo fight?
Oh my God, I missed out on a great opportunity to bet on Bivol. I'm so sad that I didn't.
You were going
to
bet on him?
I was going to.
Like Floyd?
I was going to put $100 on it. I would have gotten like $400, which is a lot for me. But I predicted that. I absolutely saw that coming. I think just the size difference. And then Bivol is an absolutely phenomenal boxer, but he doesn't necessarily do anything creative. You know, it's very fundamentally sound but basic.
Man.
But he does it very well.
Effective.
She knows about boxing. Yeah,
okay, Zurdo and Bivol, what do you think?
Oh my god, I love talking about this because yes. So, this is where I think it's going to be really different. Yes, Canelo is an excellent fighter, but what Zurdo has that Canelo doesn't have is the size advantage, of course, and Zurdo knows how to utilize both stances very, very well. So I think that's going to give Bivol trouble. Also, Bivol had the high guard like the entire fight. If he does that against him, like he's just going to rip apart the body. You know, that's going to be a great opportunity for him to hit the body. So I actually think Zurdo would win because he likes to like stand in front of you and he likes to bang, and Bivol is more of a, he wants to keep you on the outside.
Okay.
You know?
Two more. Zurdo against Bitterbyev, Joe Smith winner. Who wins and how does he do with the winner?
I think Bitterbyev would win that fight.
Okay, and I told him he would cook Bitterbyev. What do you think?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Well, he has power, 19-0, 19-0.
Yeah.
I mean, he's a great champion.